An ambitious plan has been launched tonight to evacuate Australians stranded in Wuhan by the coronavirus outbreak and place them in an island quarantine. More than 132 people are now dead in China. A new case has been confirmed in Victoria, and 16 more are being investigated here in New South Wales.
Trapped in and around the locked-off city of Wuhan, 600 Australians, now the Great Escape. A plan being hatched by Federal Cabinet's National Security Committee. A chartered Qantas flight landing in Wuhan and taking as many people as it can.
And we're particularly focused on the more vulnerable components of that population. That's young people, particularly infants, and those who are elderly.
Sydney sider Daniel Uyang is one of those desperate to get out of Wuhan.
I think getting out of there as quickly as possible is in one of our top priorities. Definitely, we are worried that this is spreading quite quickly, which is why, you know, all of us, we've been home, we've been on lockdown, we haven't left the house for the past week and a half.
Japan has just evacuated 206 of its citizens. The Australian mission could be a one-off, meaning many could still be left stranded. It'll be done on a last-in, first-out basis.
We cannot give a guarantee that this operation is able to succeed.
The exit plan is complicated. Evacuees will end up on Christmas Island and placed in quarantine for up to 14 days.
From what I've read regarding detention centres and these kind of environments, the living condition isn't the best and ideal.
Qantas has been involved in dangerous evacuations before, in Beirut in 2006, and then 5 years later from Cairo in 2011 during the Arab Spring.
We have always been there for Australians in time of need, for getting people out of areas around the globe.
The Qantas flight from Wuhan can't land on Christmas Island because the runway isn't long enough, meaning the evacuees will have to come to the mainland first, potentially Darwin or Learmonth in WA.
The video screens here at Sydney Airport are still touting travel to Beijing, but the Department of Foreign Affairs is now urging travellers to reconsider travel to China, and it's saying people should definitely not go to Hubei province or Wuhan, the epicentre of the outbreak.
And this is what everyone fears. Scientists in Melbourne have for the first time grown the coronavirus outside of China. It will help with speedy detection of potential cases and could help with testing of vaccines.
Much more importantly, that we've moved immediately to share this with our international colleagues.
At schools across Sydney, doses of confusion and concern.
Yes, definitely. I'm really worried about her.
At schools with high Chinese numbers, face masks were everywhere, despite this advice from the country's top medico.
We are not recommending that the general Australian public wear masks or take protection.
The New South Wales Health Department is urging parents of children who have recently been to China to keep them at home for 14 days. But Federal Education Minister Dan Tehan said those children should only stay at home if they were at risk.
Unless you've been in direct contact with someone who has the virus or are showing symptoms, you're fine to go to school or go to a childcare centre.
There are now 6 confirmed coronavirus cases nationally, 2 in Victoria, 4 in New South Wales. And there are 16 cases in New South Wales under investigation, ages ranging from 2 to 66 years old.
But the fact that we have 16 cases under investigation just reflects that we've broadened our testing.
Hong Kong is starting to shut its borders with mainland China. Train and ferry services suspended, flights halved, no permits to visit Hong Kong from the mainland. Mark Burrows, Nine News.
And Nine's political reporter Chris O'Keefe is with me in the studio with breaking news. Chris, what have you got for us?
Peter, the federal government has updated its health advice to anyone who has been anywhere near Wuhan, the epicentre of coronavirus. Australian health authorities are now telling people if you have travelled there to self-isolate for 14 days. So stay at home for 2 weeks and do not go to work or school. Also, if you have been in contact with anyone who is confirmed to have coronavirus, the same 2-week isolation applies. If you then feel unwell, ring ahead and go straight to hospital. Now, the details of the Qantas flight to Wuhan are still being finalised, but the Prime Minister says He is in the hands of the Chinese government. Peter, they are confident, though, that this mission will go ahead.
Good on you, Chris. Thank you.